friends, this is Nirmal here for Technique, and in this video we'll talk about the Beam app we just launched towards the end of last year. So Beam, it's also called as Bharat Interface for Money, is a mobile app developed by National Payments Corporation of India, NPCI, and it's based on the Unified Payment Interface, that's UPI, and this was launched on December 30th, 2016, and this app allows you to transfer money much faster and easily to other banks with just a mobile number, and this is pretty easy way to send money to different bank accounts. So in this video we'll talk about how to set up the Beam app, what all features it has, how to send money, how to receive money, and how to use the app. All these features we'll talk about in this video. So we have installed the app. You can just go to the Play Store and you can see Beam app. If you need to make sure that the app is from National Payments Corporation of India, NPCI, that's the official one. So this app is available in the Play Store for Android devices, and for iPhones it is also available in the App Store. So now we have installed the app, so let's just open it, and you can see this is the basic interface. So first you need to choose the language for your app. So right now we'll choose English. So other languages are also available. You can see other regional languages are also supported. So just click next, and you'll see the welcome screen. You can now send and receive money instantly using your mobile phone without having to know the bank account details for other people. So we just click next, and you can see simple and secure and super fast method of paying money using the Unified Payment Interface. Just click next. So let's get started. So first you need to access the app needs to access your SMS and phone. So let's just get started. So provide access for the app. So now you need to verify your mobile number first. So click next. You can, if you are using dual SIM card, you can select the number to verify it. So we are just going to verify it first. So now you can see the mobile number has been verified. Now this app will ask you to set up a passcode each time you open the app. So we already set the passcode, so we'll just enter the passcode and go to the next step. So in the next step, you need to select your bank account. You can use the same bank account which has the same mobile number, because mobile number need to be in sync. Only then you can use the bank account. So you can select the bank account which has the same mobile number as you verified right now. And now let's go to ICICI, click next. So now you can see that the bank account connected to this mobile number is available here. So just select that. So once you selected the bank account, you need to set the UPI pin, and for that you need to enter the last 6 digits for the debit card and also the validity date, the date up to which the debit card is valid for the same bank account. So let's just enter the last 6 digits for the debit card and also the validity date. So once you entered the debit card details, as well as the date, the validity of the card, you will ask you to enter the OTP, which will automatically be detected, and you can just set the UPI pin. So UPI pin should be entered, which should be remembered all the time, because each and every time you make the payment, the UPI pin is required. So make sure you enter a pin which you can remember. So we'll just enter the pin right now. Click OK and confirm the pin once again. So now we can see that the bank account has been added successfully, and you can see the details. The pin, 4-digit UPI pin also exists, and the bank details are being shown right now. Now we'll just show you how to add send and receive money. So what you need to do is to send money. You can just click the send money option, and you need to enter the mobile number of the person who has this UPI access. So make sure you either enter the UPI payment address or the mobile number. So if you want to enter the mobile number, that mobile number should be connected to UPI and should have a bank which is connected to this number. So we'll just try a mobile number to show this process. So click verify, and you can see the person's name along with the mobile number displayed there. So that has been automatically detected. We just entered the mobile number alone, and it has been automatically detected by the UPI, that's a Unified Payments Interface. Now we'll just enter a sample amount. So we'll just pay 10 rupees and click pay. And now it will again ask you to enter the UPI pin, because that has to be entered to confirm the processing. So we'll just enter the pin, click OK. And you can see that the money has been successfully sent to that person. that has been completed. So this is a very simple process, and if you want to request money, you can just click request money and you can enter the mobile number the same way when you entered for send money, and you can ask the person to request money, and the same process will happen. And you can also use the QR code to pay. So there is also scan and pay option. For that you need to get access to the QR code of the person. So you can generate your QR code, you can just go to the profile and you can see this is the QR code for my account. So I can just share or download this and share it with my friend from whom I want to receive money, and I can see I can share this QR code, and that will work easily, and that person can go to scan and pay, and then I can just select the scan and pay and use that QR code to scan the account. Now another option is send money via the normal bank details. So just click send money, and here you can see Aadhaar pay and account for plus IFSC. You can use Aadhaar pay or you can use the account for plus IFSC number. That's you can enter the beneficiary name, account number, confirm account number, and finally the bank IFSC code. And this is the standard process of entering. For this you need to know the actual name of the beneficiary, the account number, bank IFSC, all those things are required. But the UPI interface allows you to send money and also request money using just the mobile number. And you can also see the transactions what you have done to that person can be seen here, and you can also see the bank account. You can go and edit the UPI pin, and also you can see your profile where you can share the QR code. So this is a pretty simple process to send and receive money using the Bheem app, that's Bharat interface for money, which is being set by the UPI, that's Unified Payment Interface. So this is a quick video on the Bheem app. I hope this video was useful in sending and receiving money. So the same process can be done for request money as well as scan and pay. So thanks for watching this video. Hope this video was helpful, and don't forget to hit the like button and also hit the subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next video. Have a great day.